Welcome to week two of B Team Rocket Football. The boys had a nice 15-6 last week to kick off the season versus Lexington. And while we saw a lot of good things, the game shouldn't have been nearly that close as the Rockets turned the ball over three times in the red zone. I can imagine the coaches have drilled into the kids' head the importance of taking care of the ball this week and going forward, because better teams are going to make you pay for those miscues. Back here with BVH, the legendary BVH. So happy to have the ambient mic on with the kid working the tuba right now. We might have to shut that down in about 5 seconds. This week, the Rockets are facing the Grey Ghosts of Westford. It's absolutely spectacular day here in Reading. The captains are about to run out, and the kickoff is coming up. Rockets are going to kick off here. I don't know if they won or lost and deferred, a la Bill Belichick, but these coaches, they are the Belichicks of the Middlesex League, aren't they?
Oh, yeah.
All right, so number 24, the big man, Lucas Fleming, set to kick off. It's a nice kick by Fleming, a bomb actually, up over the head. I don't know if he touched it with his hands, or this might... This is going to be a touchback, bring it back out to the 20. That was an absolute bomb by Fleming, killed it. It's going to be first and 10 for Westford here from their own 20. All right, first and 10 here for Westford, that big defensive line for Reading in there, and we get a welcome back number 33, super athlete Stephen Webb is back after being injured. Wishbone formation. It's a handoff up the middle. Cuts in, nice job. Sean Beckenhuis comes in and closes the door. Beautiful tackle by number 41, Sean, after a little original shiftiness. It's gonna be second and 8. Second and 8, same formation here for Westford, Wishbone. It's like the old Oklahoma teams of the 70s, right, Brian? Same play, handoff to 44. Beautiful tackle right there. Who came in? Was that number 22, Damari? Let's see if that was him. No, I think it was number 30, let's see, 43, Dante Barboza came in and closed it. Looking like Damari, learning from his teammate, shooting the gap there and pushes him back 4 yards, right into third and 11 or 12 now. So nice couple of plays by Redding. Different formation here, they might be looking to pass. It's a fake, he's gonna pass it, throws it out. It's a low pass. He was open, but I think it was Barboza and Beckenhuis were all over him, so probably not the worst thing to happen there, but it's gonna be fourth down, and you might be looking at Westford to kick right here. Beautiful first series for the D for Reading. Fourth down here for Westford. Oh, it's a high snap. He is going to kick it away. Oh, it gets in there. It's blocked a little bit. It's going to be a bounce for Reading. So beautiful play, number 44, Danny Junta, put a ton of pressure on, and that's a net loss. The Rockets are going to take over first and 10 from Westford's 15. They could put a stamp on this early, send a message. Beautiful first series by Reading's D. First and 10 here for the Rockets. Who do we have under there? We have about 9 quarterbacks, we know that. It's a low snap right there. It looks like a keeper to Damari. Damari takes it for 3 or 4 yards. You know, we're joined up here in the camera booth by one Albie Kale today, BBH. Albie doesn't have a kid in the program, and actually, he wasn't allowed in the program either because he's actually too small. half of our defensive line is bigger than Albie here, but Albie is a flag football legend in coaching circles. To have him up here and see the inside of some real football is great.
Well, thanks for that warm welcome, Mr. O'Connor. I appreciate it.
We have second and call it 6 here for the Rockets. Looks like Fleming, direct snap to Lucas, the big man, falls. Oh! Crushes the first guy, gets down very close to the touchdown, right to the end zone. So it's going to be first and goal here for the Rockets, and Fleming takes it for 8 hard yards. And someone's seeing some stars right after seeing Fleming after the first one. He is a very, very tough guy to take down. Speaking of guys who are bigger than you, Albie, clearly he's bigger than 2 of us.
Well, I think if you give me a helmet and a shirt, I think I can suit up, Coach.
We might be able to sneak you in. Here we go. It's a direct snap to Damari. He puts his head down, and it's a touchdown for the Rockets. Wow, that was quick. That was all made possible by that first defensive play for the Rockets, and four plays later, they're in for the score. And early on in this game, it's 6-0, and we're going to see Stephen Webb come in, who was kicking in place of Jeremy Rosh this week. I don't know if I see Rosh's number. I got to see if he's out here, but Jeremy kicked last week. Stephen was booting the ball beautifully in practice. I talked about this last week, Brian. A lot of this is the snap and the hold, and Troy Pollock's done an awesome job as the holder. Stephen boots it. It looks like it's going to be good.
Good. Beautiful. It's good. It's good.
And what's great about this, at this level, Albie, when you kick an extra point, it's worth 2 points in Pop Warner, not one. So when you get a kid who can kick at this level, it's a huge bonus.
It's nice
bonus
to have someone who can kick.
So early on, Rockets 8, Westford nothing.
Still a long game. Still a long game.
Hey, it's like Groundhog Day again. The game all over again, and Fleming is kicking off. He bombed the last one. That's another huge kick. They move back this time to seeing how he can kick. Fielded by number 39. Nice move right there. He gets tackled about the 37-yard line. Let's see who was in there. Number 51, I think, is Zach Kenyon in there. And number 42, Derek Van Horn.
Nice.
Cameraman's son. So nice play by Derek and Zach. It's going to be first and 10 for Westford. A little bit better field position than last time. First and 10 here for Westford. Back to that familiar wishbone formation. Didn't find success with it early. That's all. Look at this. It's sort of a lateral back to 44. Nice setup play, and it tricks absolutely nobody, but this key fights for a few more yards. Danny Junta, Lucas Fleming out there. Gets cleaned up, I think, by Dante Barboza, and there is Jeremy Rosh out there. So, you know, it was a cool-looking play, and it actually should have been stopped for a loss, but credit number 44 for Westford for getting something out of nothing there. And it's 2nd and 8 right now. Going with a hurry up. In motion, number 44. It's a handoff to him. Nice cutback for him. Takes it for about 6 or 7 yards, so good cutback. In there is number 24, Fleming, number 43, Barboza, and number 15, Harrigan. So we'll look at a 3rd and 3 here, and this is a big 3rd and 3. Although at this level, when you get to midfield, you might be looking at 4-down territory anyway. Especially when you kick like they did the last time. In motion again. Oh, this one's a little more trickery there, but that one gets snuffed out very quickly. Fleming in there again. Number 32, let me see who else that was in there. It might be Barboza getting in there, but here we go, 4th down, and they're gonna go. They're making it quick, so. Quick pace here, but this is a huge one. Huge play for Westford. Handoff number 44. Oh, beautiful stop right there.
Nice.
Danny Junta got in early. In comes Kenyon. In comes Fleming. And in comes Barboza, and Rosh was there, and it's a turnover on down. So the big D for the Rockets sending a message early. And they have not quite the field position of the first one, but they're going to take over from inside Westford territory here. 1st and 10 here for the Rockets. Looks like we have Fleming, Damari. Oh no, it's Pat Harrigan under center. It's a pitch left. Oh, it's Stephen Webb getting his first carry, and he's got wheels. He gets the corner. I don't think he's going to be touched. Wow. How about adding Webb to the arsenal? We had 7 or 8 guys carry last year. He gets his hand on the ball for the very first play. And these guys just saw speed like they haven't seen in a long time. Getting Stephen out of the outside. You are not going to catch him in the open field, and he was running away with it. So Redding, early on, sending a message both defensively and offensively. Stephen Webb, who just got our 2 points for the extra point, is going to try it again right here. Let's hope he's not too tired to kick. Let's try to find Gilligan after this. All right, Webb set up for another 2-point try, extra point. Low snap, beautiful play right there. And it's just pulled left. It was a good kick, but beautiful play by Pollock to even collect it and put it in there. So with 4:57 to go in the first quarter, it's Reading 14, Westford nothing. Are we on? Little player profile here. Number 32 is Joe Gilligan, son of director of football. Joe loves pizza and the Gronk. Who doesn't, huh, Albie? But get a load of this. If Joe could be any animal, it would be an orangutan. How about that?
An orangutan?
Yeah, yeah. We'll come back to that in a sec as Fleming gets the kickoff here again. Fleming set to go again. Oh, this is a bomb too. Nice play. Picking it up there. Run back here. He's got a little bit of move there. Oh, number 33. Webb and number 42. Derek Van Horn. Beautiful play again by Derek. Wow, look at Brian Van Horn, cameraman, is peacocking around here like, hey, was that me or was that my son?
He's got a little goosebumps.
He does. Hey, getting back to Joe Gilligan, right? An orangutan. A fun fact about orangutans, Brian, they walk on all fours, but unlike other animals, they don't use their knuckles. They actually use their flat hands. And ironically, that's the way I saw Albie walking out of Chili's the other day. So Joe says, here we go. We got first and 10 here for Westford. To hand off up the middle. Oh, boy. Fleming comes in, hits him, stops him in his tracks, and they get piled on.
He's going to feel that one.
This was something that the coaches, I talked to the coaches before the game, and they said one of the things they need to work on is their gang tackling. These guys are making the first hits, and they got to come in and help out these guys. And that was a perfect example of that. So they're listening early in the game. Second and 12 here. Oh, it's that same play we had last time. Nice play just to catch
it. Nice
number
pursuit.
21 in there was Keith Richmond. And who else was in there for the tackle? Maybe 41, Sean Beckenhuis. So Joe Gilligan says his superpower would be telekinesis, Albie, right? The ability to control physical things with your mind. Right now, he's thinking, how
That's
can
awfully
I get...
awfully advanced for someone that
oh,
age,
Oh, listen,
huh?
Hey, we got big brains on this team. It's third and 12. In motion, inside handoff. He's got a little bit of room. Oh, there's Barboza closing in. Gets around the edge, though. Nice play to gain something out of there.
Nice
Let's see.
Well, it looks like an 8-yard gain.
Who picked that up? It was number 22, Danny Damari, did it. So eight-yard gain, it's going to be fourth down. You know, if you had telekinesis right now, Albie, I think you'd be trying to make Pizza World deliver us a pizza up here. See what you can do.
Hold on a second. Let me try it.
All right. Concentrate.
I'm trying. But we got a big game here. It's hard
you know
to
what?
Concentrate on pizza.
Sorry, I have to say Bertucci's because Bertucci sponsors our snack shack.
Bertucci.
All right, here we go. Fourth and three. Big play here. Oh, nicely set up play. Nice trick there. Number seven, Pollock
nice
puts
stick.
A hit on him. Also, let's see, number 43, Barboza. But that was a nice little bit of trickery there just up the middle. And it's the first down, the first one of the day for the Grey Ghosts. Very close to midfield. They got the hurry-up offense going here. They don't want these their defense to rest. In motion again, hand off to number 15. Oh, he gets strung out, number 33
nice.
Right there
nice.
Is Webb. You are not gonna get around him, and if you do, he'll catch you from behind, and Barboza was there to clean up too, so Stephen Webb's first game back, he's making his presence felt early.
That's good.
Second and pushed him back 5 yards there. Great defensive play by Webb. Second and 15. Oh, that's a nice little play. They've done that a couple of times. Oh, wow. That was
nice.
Jeremy Rush coming in. Absolutely crushed him. You know, Brian, usually what I do before the games is talk about some plays I might have missed last week. One play I didn't miss, and certainly a kid from Lexington didn't, was that straight arm that Jeremy Rush dished on him. And he powered into the end zone. What a play by Jeremy. Beautiful, and he just crushed that kid. Third and 13 right now. It's gonna be a pass here. He sets up, throws it underneath. Same thing happened last time. Beautiful coverage. Beckenhuis and Rosh were right there. And they were ready to meet it, but a low pass by, looked like Peyton Manning out there these days. Huh?
I'll tell you right now, that quarterback got stuck as soon as he released
Listen,
the ball.
Listen, I just ragged on Peyton.
Is that a flag?
We will find out. Yeah, we'll find out if it
Ruffing
was a personal
the
foul.
What do you think?
I tell you, I was ragging on Peyton Manning, and the only person happier out there is Mandy Harrigan, who despises all things Denver. That does look like a personal foul. It's going to be an automatic 15 yards and a first down. Albie. good thing you get the set of eyes up here. Look like a...
You know, I'm a little younger than you, so my eyes are a little bit better, you know?
A late hit on the quarterback. It's too bad there because that ends up being Westford's biggest play from scrimmage, a 15-yard penalty, and it's first and 10 from the 40. Outside, oh, the ball's on the ground! Ooh, beautiful play by Webb to get in there. Damari and Harrigan all right there, too. So good job by the running back for Westford just to hop on it. But if they're moving the other direction right now, it's going to be second and about, call it 17 here. Westford's got a pretty big team here, Brian.
They do.
They're not small guys out there.
They're running no huddle all day, man.
And they're running no huddle. They're going to try to keep kids, keep this big Reading line tired. Inside handoff there. Nice job by, beautiful job by Keith Richmond to keep him to go inside, and gets cleaned up pretty quickly. It's a nice little gain. So Fleming was in there, Beckett, Houston, Barboza. And so it's going to be third and long here. And this is typically four down territory anyway when you're on that side of the field at this level. So they're hurrying up again. It's called third and 10. It's going to be a pass. Oh, look at this. He's wide open out in the middle. The defensive backs for Reading bit, and it's just overthrown. Beautifully set up play. And that's one of the things we talked about last week, what they were working on, is Reading actually had a couple of issues with basically defending against the pass. Haven't done a lot of it. They had a couple of penalties last time. That time, they were just fortunate. They bit on a run, and that guy was wide open down the middle. So fourth and 10 here, they are going to go for it. To hand off right here. He's got a little bit of room. Beautiful play to trip him up right there. That looks like number 21, Richmond. And we called his name earlier, that Keith set the edge there, made him go up, and the Rockets are going to take over. Once again, the D comes up big. I bet you those guys want a little bit of a breather now, though. We got about, let's say, 21 seconds left here in the first quarter. 14, Reading, 0, Westford. All right, first and 10 here for the Rockets. It is the start of the second quarter, so we switch sides. Good field position from their own 42. Looks like Troy Pollock under center now. Damari back. Handed to Damari, falls Beckenhuis, and Danny takes it for about 4 or 5, still on his feet, call it 6 now.
A nice power run right there.
I tell you, Dan's not the biggest guy, but he might have had the most impressive runs last week. He had a couple of series where he had some beautiful cutbacks, and he's a guy who doesn't want to go down easily. So Troy is coming in with the next play. Big man Andrew Hattery. Looks like Sebastian Vollmer out there on the left tackle, doesn't he, BVH?
Oh, yeah.
They're going to be second and 5 right here for the Rockets. We have Damari back. In the shotgun is Pollock. It's going to be a handoff to Damari. Nice job by Westford. Danny does get a couple of positive yards. It's going to be 3rd and 2 right to midfield, but good job to close the gap for Westford. 3rd and short here, call it 2 for Reading. Under center is Pollock. Right there, Damari follows Beckett Houston. He dives forward. Beautiful play by Dan. And we're going to get another 4 ticks right here for Reading. Nice job by Pollock. And Damari didn't feel like waiting for Beckenhuis for the block there. He just knew he needed 3, and he saw the hole and grabbed it. First and 10 here for the Rockets. Got Beckenhuis and Damari in the backfield. Split left is Barboza. Oh, and there's Barboza right there. Oh, beautiful play. Tell you, nicely set up play, but number 11 from Westford did not get tricked, and even better, Dante's got a lot of speed. He wrapped up his legs beautifully, so great tackle. That's the best defensive play of the day for Westford. Brian, they're not letting us have a lot of time for breaks here, are they? Now, we're going no huddle for Reading either. There's no chance for you sneaking out back for a cigarette. All right, here we go. It's going to be Pollock to keep a beautiful block. Oh, boy. Damari and Barboza double-teamed him and springs him for about 5 yards. But a nice job by Troy to follow it. But that guy was coming in with a head of steam, and Damari and Barboza threw themselves at him and sprung Troy for about 5. But we're still looking at 2nd and very long here. Big play here for the Rockets. In Westford territory here. In the shotgun is Pollock to the right, Damari. Beautiful play there. We saw that one earlier. Look at Damari find the hole. Oh, he cuts up. He's still on his feet. He gets a first down. That play was beautifully executed last week. And once again, executed again, the thing that makes an option like that great is the ability for Pollock to actually sacrifice himself and hold on to it late, ditch it late, and Damari finds a hole and takes it for a huge first down here. So first and 10 from the Westford 32. Whole new offensive line in there for Rockets. And it looks like Patrick Harrigan under center. Steven Webb. And big Lucas Fleming in the backfield. It's a pitch to Webb. He follows Fleming.
What a stick by Fleming.
He gets around the outside. Steven cuts back. He's still on his feet, and he finally gets driven out by three guys. He gets about 7 yards there, maybe make it eight.
You got to mention that block by Fleming on the coming up. He absolutely crushed that kid.
He's the biggest guy on our team, Albie, and I'll tell you, you don't want to see him coming down on you.
I'd be afraid of him.
Guess what? You probably feel worse if he's coming down on you without the ball. Because guess what? He doesn't need to protect it then. He just needs to crush you. So here we are. It's going to be second and short now. Nice run by Webb. Second time touching the ball today. Webb just to the left. Oh, it looks like an inside handoff to Webb. Nice hole. He saw it. He cuts it. That's going to be a first down for the Rockets inside the red zone. So this is where the Rockets had trouble last week. They get to the 20-yard line three times, had two fumbles and one turnover on downs, and that's another thing that the coaches talked about. We talked about opening up the game, is that these guys need to be more efficient, need to take care of the ball, and make the best of their opportunities here. Harrigan under center. Webb, handle Webb, he follows Fleming again. Webb's got some room, he cuts back. Lowers the shoulder and dives to about the 12-yard line. So it's going to be another gain of eight. Max positive yardage each time Webb touches the ball. And there's not a lot of answers right now on Westford's side. After the touchdown, let's look for 81. He's got black socks. Okay, tell me what. Okay, it's going to be second and call it four here. Same setup, Webb and Fleming in the backfield. It's a handoff to Fleming this time, and he gets met immediately. Great play by number 73. But that time they try to go right to the big man, and he gets stopped for no gain. So, and like I said, you won't hear us say that too often, stop for no gain with Lucas getting the ball. That. Now Redding trying to do the hurry up here. Harrigan runs in from the sideline with the play from Coach Bob Junta, head coach Bob Junta. Under centers, Harrigan, Webb, Fleming behind him. It's a pitch out to Webb. He's following Fleming. He's going to get outside.
What a block.
Huge block by Fleming. Steven maybe went a little wider than it even had to there, but he still gains the first down, and it's going to be first and goal for Redding. Boy, another massive block by Fleming out there. I said that's one you may have Steve instead. Steve obviously has the speed to go out wide and get around people. That's one you might want to keep it tighter and stay right behind them. He's going to spring you for something. We might be talking about six right now, but I think we're going to be talking about it in just a second anyway. 3:35 to go in the half. Harrigan under center. It's a pitch out to Webb.
Fleming leading again.
Oh, beautiful block out there by number, 80 was out there. That was Trevor Conroy did a beautiful job setting him off and opening up the outside, and Steven's very, very close to a touchdown. He's already got one today. He's probably upset he had to carry the ball four times in this series instead of just the one last time. So we have second and goal here for the Rockets from inside the four. You may see the big guy's name called right now, Fleming again. And if not, just throw Webb right behind him. Harrigan under center. Hand off to right there, right behind Fleming. That's what we talked about, right? That's what we talked about. Stick right behind the big guy, and Steven goes in easy. Second touchdown of the day for Webb with just about over 2 minutes to go in the half, and Redding is
really putting a hurting on Wexford right here in the first half. All right, let's find try the kick here for two. 20 to nothing now, trying to make it deuces. Nice kick by Steven, and it is good.
Nice
job by Steve. Two out of three good today, and that second one he had had plenty of mustard on it, just pulled it. So those are big plays here, and the Rockets 22, Wexford 0. Hey, number 81 is Cole Tully. A little player profile on him, Albie. Cole's favorite food is steak. And I'm blocking. Hold on, I'm blocking my notes over here. Hey, we're professionals up here. Cole's favorite food, steak and cheese sub.
That's a good one.
One of my favorites.
Oh my gosh, I could use one right now. Who's got the best steak and cheese in town?
Anthony.
Anthony, you think
so? I'm an Anthony fan.
I will tell you this. I'm going to vote for Columbo's steak and cheese calzone. Have you had one
of
those?
Talking about subs to calzone.
Well, listen,
Anthony makes a good steak and cheese calzone,
you know?
Too, though.
Oh, yeah. We got to check that out. All right, we're going to get back to Fleming here, kicking off, and we're going to come back to Cole, finish up his player profile soon. Another big kick right here. It's going to squib way out to a good bounce there. That's a live ball right there. All right, so Wexford's going to take over. Back to Cole here, his favorite books of the Harry Potter series, and not surprisingly, his favorite female celebrity, Emma Watson. You know who that is?
Can't go wrong with that.
Emma Watson, she's the girl who actually played Hermione, right? In the Harry Potter movies. Now, this is what I never really got about that. The whole Ron and Hermione thing. Didn't everyone think Harry should have been with Hermione? Right? Or in this case, maybe Cole, right? Cole's favorite male celebrity, Anthony Rizzo. Remember that guy? No, you don't, because he was in the farm system for the Red Sox. And now he just hit his 30th home run for the Cubs. He was a big bat that we gave up, I believe, in part of the Hanley Ramirez trade. So here it is, first and 10 here with a couple of minutes in the first half here. Oh, it's a tough snap. Hands it off to number 11. He's got a lot of room in front of him. Nice run right there and a nice tackle by number 15,
great
Harrigan.
Tackle.
So beautiful play. Cole Tully's got a brother. I think playing, he's up in Notre Dame right now. Beautiful pitcher, Scott, right? He's a superstar, playing down in the Cape League. Great, great athlete and awesome baseball player and pitcher for Notre Dame right now. So he's got the genes, that's for sure. Second and four. Oh, it's a direct snap, number 44. Oh, Webb almost has him. Cuts back and Barboza rips him down. Wow, Webb and Rosh busted in there, but credit number 44. Barboza takes him and slams him to the surface. So nice play by Dante. It's going to be third and four here. Quarterback coming in with a play, checking his lit end here. This looks like a passing situation for these guys, but it's going to be an in-sup. The fake handle. They did that play to success last time. Nice play by number 33, Webb and Barboza to close on him.
Webb did a nice job of containing right there.
That play got him for big yardage there, but not this time. Still 4 yards there, but it's going to be fourth down, and they're going to do a hurry up. They need this one. They cannot get stuffed. Oh, nice job by them to take it. Redding has got to get the head in the game there. We got two guys on the left not even looking at it. Fourth and a foot, you have to be ready immediately, and credit Wexford for taking advantage. That's where the quick no huddle has helped those guys. So first and 10 here for Wexford. It's gonna be a pass, he sets it up. Three times in a row they've set it up, and to be honest with you, all three of those times have been very, very well defended. So, and all three of those times a short pass. And I don't even know if that was on purpose. I mean, a couple of times you've seen a guy just want to hang his player out to dry there with a big
defense
lick.
Defense is what wins games, Tim. Defense.
Some cutting edge color commentary by Albie Kale right there. Second and 10 here for Wexford. It's gonna be a pass again. He sets this up. Jeremy Rosh was there. Nicely set up play, and those are the types of things we were talking about defending, is that you never wanna get caught flat-footed, and just thrown a little bit too far for number 11, but he ran a pretty nice route. It's gonna be third and 10 coming up. Third and 10 here for Wexford. Having trouble getting anything going against this Rocket D.
But Bob Junt has been, Coach Junt has been happy to keep the big line in there almost the whole time. It's a throw across the middle. Beautiful play and catch, number 11. He sneaks by Harrigan. It's going to be up to Troy Pollock, and Pollock pulls him down. So nice play across the middle. He looked like he was, Julian Edelman out there, number 11, right? Cut across, nice pass and catch, and a nice run after the catch. So that's a beautiful play for Westford right there for a big gain into Rocket territory, and they'd love to get something on the board here before the half. 39 seconds is what the clock says. I don't know if that's really true. But this big defensive line for Reading, they've been out there quite a bit. Might be a little winded in the snow huddle.
It's all about the conditioning, Tim. It's all about the conditioning.
All right, here we go. First and 10 here after the beautifully executed play by Westford. First time they've been maybe this deep in Rocket territory. It's going to be another pass. Throws out underneath, and that's at that time it works. Gets closed on very quickly by Rosh, and over the top comes 51, Zach Kenyon. So nice open field tackle, but that play we've seen a couple times. That's the first time it worked well for Westford. Let's call it second and 6 here for Westford. Under a minute left in the half here. It's going to be another pass. Throw it out underneath. Beautiful play. Nice stick right there by Rosh. Cleaned up again by Kenyon. So those guys doing a nice job. But that one's going to be close to the first down, depending on forward motion here, or forward progress. All right, here we are, third and short. Throw underneath. It's sort of a poor wobbly pass thrown behind number 39, but you can count on them going at it on fourth down here. Here at BVH, and go talk to the cheerleaders and see if we could, they would come up and introduce themselves, but I think they are going to go out and we'll get them on at halftime. Fourth and 1 here for Westford. Stacked heavy right. It's an inside handoff to number 47, and he gets it. Gets met by Fleming, but he's going to get the first down here. Clock is running. I don't know if we're going to run out of time. Waiting to move the chains here. It's going to be a pass here for Western. Oh, big pressure by number 21 was Richmond coming right in, and Westford throws it away, so they do stop the clock here. I don't know if this is going to be the half. Looks like it is the half. So they get one play off here, and on a beautiful day out here, Reading has really had their way with the Grey Ghost today. It's Reading 22, Westford 0. Hey, very happy to have the cheerleaders from Reading join us here today. We're going to have them come up here and introduce themselves, and little did we know that they actually have a routine they have to do at halftime. So here are the girls from Reading. Let's watch. Nice job there by the girls. That's pumping me up right now, Brian, for the second half, huh?
I can't wait.
I can't wait to take a break right now. First of all, you know how much I love hearing myself talk. Oh, every once in a while, I like to take a breath, though.
You talk.
And so that look at this. For the first time ever, I've actually seen another team have more people than Reading, the Westford girls here. But nice job by the girls from Reading, and we'll be back to pick up the second half shortly. All right, guys, listen, we're going to do a new segment this week. And this one's called The Coaches Answer the Kids Survey. I sent out this thing this week. In about 2 minutes, head coach Bob Junta got back to me. He was absolutely thrilled to be asked what his answers were for the survey. So, Coach Bob loves Italian food. You know who his favorite male celebrity is?
Do we want to know?
Assistant coach Dan Damari. Yes. So his favorite movie is The Godfather, and if he could be an animal, he said it'd be a racehorse. Correct me if I'm wrong, BBH, but I think a racehorse found a very unfortunate end in The Godfather. I can only assume the coach would like to be a horse, but maybe not that one. Right? Now this is where things get really interesting for Coach Junta. His favorite book
The Elegant Universe, a science book on string theory. I have not read this one, BVH, but as you know, string...
Oh, really? String, you haven't read that one?
Well, as you know, and Albie knows, of course, and Coach Kevin McCadden joined us here, too. You know, string theory is really about reconciling Einstein's general theory and quantum mechanics. You know, for the uninitiated, that means making sense of the largest things in the cosmos and the behaviors of the very smallest things in the universe. Sort of like coaches Dan Beckenhuis and Dan Webb standing next to each other. So, I'm very happy to get BVH reading this week. I gave him a book this week. Yeah. He says the very last book I read before this one was The Very Hungry Caterpillar. So good for you, BVH.
You got a lot of pictures?
Some 47 years ago was your last book. Exactly. And I'm happy to get you back on board, because now I'm very, very interested in Coach Giunta, huh? He's dropping some knowledge, big fan of science. I like him even more. Okay. Hold on. We can't, just like the Patriots, after putting a pounding on the team, they're going to get the ball back. So this is the first kickoff for Westford. Back deep, it looks like Barbeau. It's going to be a squib kick. Nice job right there. I think it was number 72, Andrew Hatter. He pounces on it. So they try a squib. That's what the old Giunta teams used to do all the time. Constantly squib, but you get a guy who can kick like Fleming.
Would you do that against this Reading offense?
I don't know. It's a tough one. You try to get the ball back.
Great field position for them right now.
Oh, yeah.
It's going to be inside Westford territory. So at the beginning of the third quarter, up 22-0, Reading's going to take over. It looks like Fleming in a quarterback, as if they haven't seen enough. The big man hand off the ball to him. So this will be a time in the game you're going to start seeing Coach Giunta start rolling a lot of different kids through here. You have Fleming in the backfield, looks like, with Beckenhuis. Fleming follows Beckenhuis, cuts back and runs over number 51. Look at him on the ground, the kid. Hopefully he's okay. But he just felt what it means to say hello to Lucas Fleming after a run. It's going to be second and five here. Call it second and five here. We have the number 55 getting looked at. Hopefully he's okay. Took a big hit from Fleming. Looks like Harrigan in, following Beckenhuis. Nice block in front there. And Patrick gets outside, gets the first down. He's still on his feet. Wow, beautiful run by Patrick. He does not want to go down, and he's still not going down. Harrigan said, no thanks, you're not putting me on the ground. Just kept running. So beautiful run by Patrick. Come back. Okay, here we go. All right, first and 10 here for the Rockets. You have the two guys holding one of the direct snaps, and it is one. He's the keeper. Looks like Pollock. Wow, beautiful tackle right there. Was not fooled at all. Number 39 closed on Pollock and closed on him quickly. So Troy's typically pretty shifty, but that was a nice play by number 39 for Westford. And they need a few more of those if they want to get themselves back in the game. Fleming and Beckenhuis back. We got Joe Gilligan in there. We got Keegan Lee in there. Dylan Lee. It's going to be Westford jumps. It's going to give him 5 yards here. We'll come back in a sec. All right, here we go. Call it second and seven now. Beautiful defensive play, but the 5 yards, they push back. They get right back in the penalty. Nice job by Fleming. Wow, he's got roomy. Nice job shifting hands there.
He's gone.
Boy, look at Lucas. I tell you, it looked like the guys didn't want to come in and hit him on that one.
I was just going to say that.
Yep. After some punishing runs in the first half, Lucas did a nice job of shifting the ball in the left hand and takes it in virtually untouched, and I don't blame Westford for that. Let's see if we have Webb come in or Rosh come in and try and kick an extra point. I think they have to go for one now because they get to 28 and they're, I think when they get to a certain level, they make. All right, looks like the Rockets are going to go for one here with Harrigan and Beckenhuis in the backfield. It's a keeper for Harrigan. Harrigan just goes down in the middle to keep it at 28. So looks like going into halfway through the third quarter, it is the Rockets 28, the Grey Ghosts 0. All right, with the Rockets up 28-0, the Pop Warner rules will have them move the ball back for kickoffs. Some 20 yards here. We saw this a couple times last year when Reading put up some big scores as well. So the big man Fleming's going to kick from the 20. Nice kick. Oh, that's a live ball right there. Gets picked up by number 44. He's a good player for Westford. Nice cutback. Wow, he's still on his feet. Ooh. Nice job. And Bob Bolza wraps him up high. It's a good tackle. I don't think he got him by the horse collar, but that's one where you want to, Bob Bolza's first year, you want to say hit him right in the hips and the legs. So that's a very good athlete, but just a first-year football player here. A lot of guys who are tough runners aren't going to be tackled up that high. So it's going to be first and 10 for Westford from the Reading 45. First and 10 here for the Rockets. Joey Gilligan, Dan O'Connor in the middle of that line. Danny Junta out right. Hand off to 44, nice cut up right there. Another high tackle right there. That's the one that we just talked about, right? You can't tackle him high. And he pulls it for almost 10 yards there. Those big runners, you gotta go low on them, right? Focus in on the belt buckle and take him down.
Legs.
Second and three here for Westford. Wishbone formation. It's a handoff. It's going to follow number big 44. Nice cutback. Nicely tripped up right there. Looks like number, let's see who got him there. Number 40, all right, beautiful. Nice tackle by Matt Sagala in there. So Sagala's name getting called here. We got Derek Van Horn, Steven Needham in a linebacker corner right now. Hand off to number 44. Oh, good penetration right there. Number 64, Adam Dima was in there. Slowed him down a little bit. Dima almost had him in the backfield. Didn't see who wrapped him up there. I was too busy watching Dima bust through the line.
It was number 42.
That Derek Van Horn, there we go.
DVH.
Called DVH's name a couple of times. I told you, Dad's peacocking around here. Like, oh my gosh, did you see what I did? I mean, my kid did. Nice play, we've seen that play again. Wow.
That another play, tackle,
that
DVH.
Play looks good. DVH in there closing. Number 82 in there is Patrick DeRoss too. So DeRoss and DVH. DVH is looking like Rodney Harrison out there today.
Rodney Lott.
Oh, Ronnie Lott, okay.
42.
Hey, this is his dream, not yours. Okay, let's go. Third and seven here for Westford. Oh, and again, Dima in there. Wow, he's got room on. Nice, number 53 right there was Steve Needham, get his hand on him. But another huge play by Dima coming across, and they're running away from him, so. But a big game for number 44. He's a tough runner for Westford. It looks like it's gonna be a first down. It's going to be first and 10 for Westford. Right up the gut right there. Oh, nice spin move. And then he gets absolutely crushed by Needham. So Stevie Needham in there puts a lick on him. I was talking to Director of Football Gilligan. He said Needham was over his house last night, and they were carbo loading for the game. And I said, why don't you let the kids carbo load, not you, Joe. All right, here we go, second and eight. Oh, the nice little misdirection move. He's got a little room, but I tell you, he probably should have cut up. He faked himself out there, and Sagala picks him up. Adam Dima in there as well, and once again, Stevie Needham's name. So Stevie Needham's looking great out there. Got the big line in there, 72 Hattery, 70 Lynch. He's in there, Dave Lynch. '82 DeRoss on that line, too. A couple of big boys there. It's going to be a pass here. Oh, it's set up beautifully again. DVH was the guy. He was tasked with covering him on that one. Good thing that was overthrown, huh, Dad?
Yeah.
No, it's okay. No. Hey, nicely set up play, just overthrown by Westford, but they're not afraid to pass the ball. That's one thing you don't really see the Rockets do. Of course, you don't need to pass the ball when you steamroll people. But Coach Junta likes to mix it up only occasionally on the passes. Call it fourth down here. He throws it out underneath. We've seen that play. Nice play. Oh, Needham was right there. DVH is right there. Oh, big crunching tackle at the end. See what that was. Maybe 52 was Andrew Fatino coming in, putting a lick on him. Zach Kenyon was there as well, but it's going to be a first and down, a first and goal here for Westford. Hey, we got a timeout here on the field, so right now we'll do another player profile. Number 23 is Loyal Alexander. What a name, huh? I think it's awesome. His favorite food is lobster. Favorite athlete, Mike Trout. Got a little sea thing going there. Trout, lobster, it's got the whole thing happening. Mike Trout's a beast. You know, he's the only guy to ever hit 30 home runs and steal 40 bases his rookie year. His first major league hit, laid down a bunt. Even the big guys can do it. He's got some wheels. Loyal would like to be an Eagle, and keeping to that theme, his superpower would be to fly. Makes sense, yeah? His favorite book, Diary of a Wimpy Kid, Roderick Rules. Hilarious. I stole that from my 10-year-old daughter and read it. I didn't let her keep it for like a month. There we go. Back to the game over here. We'll get back to Loyal in a sec. It's going to be first and goal here for Westford. Right up the middle of big number 44. He cuts up. Gets met by a bunch, but he may be in. And he is. So Westford gets on the board, and number 44 has been a power player for them. Of course, they benefit from the excellent field position when they move him back. So with 9 minutes to go, Westford gets on the board. We'll see if they go for a one or two here. Kid books and movies are actually way too funny for us adults, weren't they?
I watched Speed.
How about the kid who played Rowley? That kid was hilarious. All right, there looks like they're going to kick too. They'd like to get a couple on the board here and cut into the Rocket lead, cut it to 20. Nice kick right there, and he just goes out to the right. He had the distance, just pushed it a little bit right. So Westford does get on the board. Nice run. Good offensive series for them. Number 44 in particular showing carrying the bulk of the workload there. With 9 minutes to go in the third, it's the Rockets 28, Westford 6. All right, Westford is ready to kick off here after getting on the board here against the Rockets. Oh, it's another squib kick right there. You better go get it. That's a live ball right there. Nice job back there. Looks like Webb, and Webb's going to go down to one knee. Takes a little hit he probably didn't need to take, but it's going to be first and 10 here for the Rockets from their own 30 coming up. Oh, it's going to be first and 10 here for the Rockets. That's a direct snap to number 71 in there. Beautiful. Number 71 is Pat Dwyer. Oh, I love Pat Dwyer and his dad, Joe. A couple of classics. As we know from last year, Pat's mom and I went to school together at BC. So she used to spy me as I went across the quad.
Who didn't?
Back in the day.
Who didn't?
Oh, listen.
Good-looking guy like yourself.
She used to get very
didn't?
Jealous, Trish Dwyer. Love the Dwyers. Pat getting a carry right there up the middle. Let's see what we have here on second down. Oh, it's right there. That's our man, Loyal, right there. Loyal was under center and dropped the snap, but he takes it off.
Big guy, Loyal's got some moves, I'll tell
takes
you.
Takes it off the end, guy, and Loyal gets some positive yardage right there. So, nice job for Loyal. As Coach Junta gets some guys in a quarterback here up a bunch. So, it's going to be third and 9 here. Loyal getting some positive yardage even after the missed snap right there. Let's see who's in there now. Oh, it looks like Wasabi Masucci, Anthony Masucci in there. Direct snap to Masucci, follows Beck and goes. Oh, look at Masucci! Oh, there he goes! Masucci's got it! Oh, what a play! Oh, gosh!
I'm not seeing big men rumble!
Oh, he looked like Vince Wilfork on an interception there, Masucci. But they got a flag there, and I think it was a hit from behind. Tackle, the big man takes it for a huge gain.
He's got to get more carries.
He's running immediately off to the side for oxygen right now. But Big Masuch does a great job. He gets the high five from his dad. Oh no, he just left his dad hanging right there. His dad, hey, his dad's peacocking down there like you were up here, DBH. Oh my gosh, look at him. He's just like, yep.
Pulling out the pen to sign off.
Hey, here's the good move. Who did I have in running back for my fantasy this week? Anthony Masucci.
Anthony Masucci.
Boom. He's going to try it again. Look at Masucci imploring people. Block you. Block for me. No more penalties. It's like Earl Campbell saying, don't call back my great runs. Masucci back in there. He's going to go left side now. He gets mad early. They learned quickly on Masucci. They have to throw many, many guys on him.
He reminds me a little bit of LeGarrette Blount.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, he does, yeah. You know what? Very, very similar running styles. And here comes Masuch right now.
I thought about it.
Beautiful. Deamer is, okay, Adam Deamer is on the sideline saying, give me the ball, coach. And there he goes in. He's going to be the quarterback for this play. So, a little bit of fun here for the boys when you're up a bunch. Get the guys some hands on the ball. And Adam Deamer's a bull, too.
Like to see him. He can move, too. Let's see what Adam's got. Fourth and four here, though. Oh. We got some motion on the line there. It's going to move him back to make it fourth and nine. So Rocket's going to push it back one. We'll give Deemer a shot coming up. Fourth and nine. Deemer in the backfield. He's going to follow Beckenhuis. He follows Sean. Oh, that's a flag right there. Looked like the only way you stop Deemer is you grab his face mask, and I think that's going to move him forward. I don't know if that's an automatic first down. Let's see what they call it. Oh, they gave me a penalty for running outside the tackle at this stage, though. This is one of those weird rules in Pop Warner that says when you're up a bunch, you have to keep the offensive plays inside the tackle. And Deemer looking for daylight busts outside the tackle. How do you tell a kid not to run for the daylight? And sort of a weird circumstance here. So he actually declines it. So that's fourth down. So the Grey Ghosts are going to take over here with good field position. And in comes a whole new defense for Bob Junta's team. It's Sean Beckenhuis. We'll get him and say, yep, here we go. It's going to be first and 10 here for the Grey Ghosts. A couple minutes left in the game here. Nice hand up. Oh, beautiful. Deemer again gets in there. Couldn't take it himself, but Adam Deemer has been a powerhouse off the line. Almost takes him down, but gets Pat Duros to help him out. So Deemer can't be stopped on that line. They have no answer for him. And he's coming from across the other side, too. They're running away from him, and he's still getting in the backfield.
He's in beast mode.
He's in beast mode.
He's in beast mode.
He's so mad about that penalty running outside tackle. Here we go.
He's at seven.
Handoff number two outside. Nice block ahead of him. Doesn't stay with him. I think it looks like number eight is over there, which is Evan Tice. Is it Tice? Is that how you pronounce it?
Evan Tice.
Nice. Evan Tice with a nice tackle on the side. In comes 81 Cole Tully. Loyal Alexander in there. A couple of the player profile boys in there today. Third and long here for Westford. It's going to be that swing pass. Oh, nice play. Just let him a little bit. But who was there? Number 42. That kid did not want to see 42 there. I mean, he could have easily caught that, but he looked up and he saw the laser eyes, the focus of DVH out there. He didn't want any part of him. Fourth down here for Westford. See if they got a first down play in their bag. Look for a pass. It's back. It is going to be a pass. He fires it up, and oh, boy. Back there was number nine. I think it was Giancarlo Musto. Remember the worm from last year?
Oh, yeah.
Giancarlo Musto back there deep, and might have picked that one up. But guess what? Better off that he didn't catch it because it's fourth down, so they turn it over. Let's go down here. Number 41 is on the bench. Is Sean Beckenhuis. He's got his helmet off there, right? Oh, looks like they're lining him up already. I'll tell you, I'll get in one more profile with Beckenhuis. His favorite food, mom's meatballs. His favorite male celebrity, Luke Kuechly. His favorite female celebrity, Kate Upton.
Nice.
Wait a second. Great. Who filled this out, Sean Beckenhuis or Dan Beckenhuis? I think that was Dad. All right, hey, his favorite place to visit, Norway. Has he been to Norway, or is that a place he wants to go?
Where's Norway?
He looks Norwegian, doesn't he? With that blonde hair, right? So, hey, great win by the Rockets here today. Never really was in question, and you know what, even though the score was big and they didn't have an answer, Westford certainly doesn't look like a bad team. They just met their match today. And the return of Stephen Webb in the backfield was a huge lift for the Rockets as he just scored a couple times today. And great plays by Adam Deemer. Great plays by the big offensive line, Lucas Fleming crushing kids out there. So beautiful win for the Rockets. They start out 2-0. We're here next week as well. I don't know, who do we have next week, Brian?
11 o'clock against Wakefield.
11 o'clock game against Wakefield right back here. And beautiful day for football. The Rockets get off to a 2-0 start. And we'll see you next week.